This video will show you how to use the Limble work request system. Some companies call the work request system a maintenance ticketing system or a problem reporting system. In this video, I'll just call it the work request system. The work request system allows people to submit a work request to the maintenance team so they can work on those problems as needed. They do not need to be a Limble user to submit a maintenance request. One great thing about the Limble work request system is that you can set up and use it in just a few minutes. That is why using the work request system is the fastest way for most companies to get value from the Limble software. The maintenance team will see three big benefits if their company uses the work request system. First, better information. People will be required to give you the information you need in order to solve the problems at your facility. Second, automatic organization. You will easily be able to see every work request that gets submitted. You can make sure that they will be organized by problem type, priority, and asset. Third, fewer interruptions. Now people will not have to interrupt the team to tell them about a problem. Rather, they will submit a work request and you will address the problem based on your schedule and priorities. All of these benefits will save your team time and allow you to get more done with less resources. For most companies, we recommend you start using the work request portal as soon as you have some assets listed in Limble. Let me show you how to find the link to the work request portal. First, select Set Up Work Requests in the left-hand navigation. This is the link to the work request portal. You can share it with other people. Later in this video, we'll talk more about options for sharing the work request portal link. If you want to change what is in the work request form, select the Customize button. The Advanced Work Request tutorial will go more in depth on all of the customization options. For now, I will just point out that work requests will be sent to anyone who is a manager in Limble. In my account, you can see that Bruce is our only manager. I'll leave that setting for now. The other setting that I want to point out is that comments will be sent to the person submitting their request over email if they provide their email address. They will also get an email when the task is completed. I'll show you how that works in a minute. Now I'm going to select the work request link so you can see the process for submitting a work request. Here is what the work request form looks like by default. Let's say that I am an accountant at your company and I noticed a broken sprinkler in the parking lot. I would write broken sprinkler head as the title of the request. Next, I would provide more information. The leak looks pretty bad. Some people have said that it feels redundant to have a title and a description. That is by design. We have found that people provide more information when you require they add a title and a description. The purpose of the work request portal is to give the maintenance team better information and to save them time. Next, I'll add my name as the requester and my email address. Because I am adding my email address, I'll receive an email when a comment is left on the work request or when someone resolves the work request. Next, I select the correct asset. In this case, I'll select landscape. The next option here is to upload a photo. I think this is one of the most powerful features of the work request system. Many people who submit problems do not have the technical expertise to describe problems in a way that is helpful for the maintenance team. However, they can easily take a photo of the issue. I'll select the Add Picture button. Since I'm doing this from my computer, I'll upload a photo that I have saved. I can draw on the photo if needed. If I were doing this from a mobile device, I'd be able to take a picture using the device's camera. Here I am taking a photo of a burned out light bulb. Now I am ready to submit the work request. Remember how we have work requests getting assigned to managers? Well, the manager on the account just received a notification on their mobile device letting them know that a work request was reported. I'm going to view the work request from my Manage Work screen. To get the latest data, I'll need to hit the refresh button. Now I can see the work request that came in. If I leave a comment on the work request, the person who submitted it will receive an email with my comment. If they reply to that email, I'll receive a notification and their comment will appear here in the comment section. When I complete the work request, the person who submitted the request will receive an email letting them know the problem has been resolved. Now that you have seen how the work request system works, I want to share with you an industry best practice. Maintenance professionals are constantly being interrupted by people telling them about problems. However, those problems are not always the highest priority task for the maintenance team at that moment. That means that maintenance professionals are often working on a top priority task when they get interrupted by a coworker to look at a lower priority problem. That is why the industry best practice is to politely explain that you can't work on their issue until they have submitted a work request. You can explain that this keeps you organized and accountable for your work. If you follow this best practice, your team will be more efficient. Keep in mind that there will be some exceptions, like a broken pipe that is gushing water on the floor. Next, let's talk about the best way to share the work request portal with people in your company. I'll go back to the Set Up Work Request screen. As I mentioned earlier, anyone who has this link can submit a work request. Here are the three most common ways that maintenance teams share the work request link with their company. They ask their IT department to place the link on their company intranet or website. They email every employee and ask them to save the link. They put their link in their email signature. Another way to share the work request portal with your coworkers is to use the QR code. This QR code is a graphical representation of the work request link. With a modern cell phone, all you have to do is turn on your camera and point it at the QR code, and then select the notification that appears on your screen. You can print this QR code and place it in a noticeable location around your facility. Keep in mind that you can submit a work request for any asset using this QR code. If you want to create a QR code for a single asset or a group of assets, you can do that by printing out an asset's work request QR code. To find that QR code, select the asset and then select the QR code icon. When someone scans this QR code, they will see the work request portal with the asset already selected. If you want to print multiple QR codes, you may want to consider getting a label printer to save you time. There is a printer with industrial strength labels that many of our customers use. To learn more about this printer, go to the Help Center and search Dymo. This article will teach you how to easily print as many custom labels as you need. This is the end of the beginner's tutorial for work requests. Check out the advanced tutorial for customizing your work request portal. If you have any questions, please contact us using the chat. There is an entire team of real humans who want to help you accomplish your maintenance goals, and all you need to do to get their help is to start a conversation here. Thank you for choosing Limble.